Y'all, Joe Biden went through this crowd. He was shaking hands, hugging folks, kissing babies, and taking selfies. But he got to a situation where he had a woman. I'm going to be politically correct. A woman of color. And it seemed like he skipped over this woman. Like he looked her in the face and didn't recognize her. He didn't see her. He didn't acknowledge her. And she was standing there. And I saw one caption on the X platform that said, when you realize that your hero is a racist. Y'all, I'm going to pull this video up so y'all can see it. I don't know if y'all saw it before, but you about to see it now. It troubled my spirit because I know his history. See, I know that when he fought against integration of schools and said that it would turn the schools into a racial jungle. He didn't want your kids with his kids. I get it. He didn't want your dirty, brown, black kids with his kid. Got his crackhead kid in the Yale law. Ain't that something? Let's go. Urban Southern Cookie, I did it again. That's just it. Let's expect it, sis. That's just what it's gonna be. You my sister. You Urban Southern Cookie to me. You gonna change your name 100,000,000 times. It's gonna be Urban Southern Cookie. That's what it is. That's what it started out as. That's what I feel in my heart. She says, Gerald, I'm urban. I'm Southern, and my nickname given to me by my father is Cookie, hence Urban Southern Cookie. I'll shout on that, Urban Southern Cookie. Thank you for your support, sis. Appreciate you so much. Urban Southern Cookie, aka Southern Cookie Cutter, y'all. Don't get it twisted. Katie says, oh, yeah, I felt that too, Katie. Oh, like, oh. And this video is kind of, it's edited. But the man came up and he was shaking hands with folks, taking selfies with folks. And it seemed like he got to her and was like, you don't exist. Humble Strong said, she got to wake up. Oh, yeah. Yeah, let's leave it right there. She got to wake up. I've seen some references online where they express that same sentiment in a different way. We just gonna leave it right there. Edited and truncated. She gotta wake up. Bernie said that's what racists do. Well, Bernie, when we look at his history, we see a certain thing. We see that he moves a certain way. We see that he said certain things. Southern cookie cutter. I gotta read it in order to get it right. So that young lady was embarrassed and hurt publicly. What a shame. However, was inside Joe Biden, and his heart is displayed clearly right there, captured. Can't escape it, y'all. They're gonna try to spin it. I've been watching the news today, y'all. And this White House has been spinning every which way till Sunday on all sorts of things, all sorts of questions by the media who seems to be turning on this man. Y'all, if you Joe Biden and CNN turns on you, MSNBC turns on you, oh my goodness, there we go again. There go that question. What is we gonna do? Well, his family says, don't drop out. Because if you drop out, then we can't pardon Hunter Biden with all these felonies that he's going to get convicted of. He already got felonies on the gun charge. 3 felonies, I believe. Now he's going to face charges in California on tax fraud, tax evasion here in this state. We know they colluded with the DOJ to let certain crimes lapse. Certain crimes that implicated Joe Biden in the foolery. We know what's going on, y'all. This is corruption at its highest level. I'm just going to say it. It's treason, if you ask me. I've been presented with enough evidence to where, y'all, if I was on the jury, I would convict. Treason, espionage. Convict this man. Has used his power in government to enrich himself and his family. And this is the thing that kills me, y'all, because the real villain of this story is high now somewhere, not on camera. One Who Cares says another reason we should pass him on November 5th, 2024. I feel you, sis. I feel you. But when I look at it from a macro lens and I say, you know what, y'all, if we rewind the tape, we'll see that there was a president of the United States. Y'all loved him. Seemed like some of y'all worshiped him. Hey, I'm guilty. Some of y'all call me MAGA, but I voted for the brown guy twice and I voted for the orange guy twice. So make of that what you will. But when Barack Obama was president of the United States, y'all, he had Joe Biden as a vice president. Some of the things Joe Biden did as vice president are now coming to light, and we're able to look at that and say, oh my God, your vice president was so crooked. He also had a secretary of state, y'all. Anybody know who that was? Drop it in the chat. Anybody know who the Secretary of State was under Barack Obama? Cynthia Baggett is here. Thank you. Appreciate your support. Does anybody know who the Secretary of State was under Barack Obama? That woman who had a secret server in her garage. That woman who was emailing back and forth between foreign governments on that secret server so she wouldn't be subject to FOIA. No, some of y'all with it. I see you, MAGA Dog 73. I see you, J-Ro 49. I see you, Katie. She said, Hillary Clinton. Oh, my goodness. Oh my goodness, Katie, I hope I don't get Clinton for saying this. Southern Cookie Cutter says, Hillary, I should be locked up and investigated Clinton. Well, that's a long middle name, but it sure is appropriate. So y'all, if you are the president of the United States, let's just think about this for a second. Let's just put on our thinking caps like a red beanie. Like a tinfoil hat. Let's just put it on and think for a second and say, if you're the president of the United States, right? You're the president. And here go your vice president cutting up all over the world, in Ukraine, in Romania, taking money from all over the place. And here go your secretary of state cutting up just as bad, if not more, taking hundreds of millions of dollars from all over the world for the Clinton Foundation. Got a secret server in the garage, got her staff working with these cell phones. And when Congress subpoenas these cell phones, they destroy them all. They smash them with hammers, say, you want the crumbs? This is the phone. Do you want the crumbs? Do you want the broken screens, the little glass particles? That's all that's left of the phone. We smashed them all. We use bleach bit on the server to make sure you can never recover anything off of it. Y'all, in an administration so corrupt, do you believe as you sit here in this chat, do you think that the president didn't know nothing about that? Come on, y'all. Magadol says, never forget when Americans died in Benghazi. Yeah. Yeah. We ain't forgot. Magadol, we ain't forgot. Do any of y'all think that the Brown president didn't know anything about this? All these things, all this criminality, all this activity that was going on in his administration, y'all, it's said, it's rumored that he was sending emails back and forth to the private server. You can't say that you didn't know about the private server when you contacting folks on the private server. How'd that work, Mr. President? The most corrupt administration of our lifetime. Then your 8 years are over. And you say, oh, well, now I'm going to get my payout. From the different media companies. This is how they funneled the money, y'all. You do what we need you to do while you're in office, and you'll be rewarded when you're out of office. So now that you're out, here go media contracts and production deals and all kinds of things that make you one of the most richest brown men in the world. What did you do to earn it? What movies have you produced prior to this to earn it? What are your production credits? Well, we can't find none. But it was a way to funnel the money to you for the things that you did in office or the things that you let slide by pretending you didn't see while you were in office. Yo, this is your corrupt government, and they don't like it when I get on this platform and say this kind of stuff. That's probably why it took so long for me to find a video that was my own content. Because folks are tripping on this platform, and I get it. But you know what? I'm going to stand 10 toes down. I'm going to make it do what it do. And I'm going to keep it real with y'all until they cut my water off. Until they tell me I can't say it no more. Till they tell me that it can't be what it once was. Let me see if I can find this video that I really wanted to bring to y'all, because we saw how Joe Biden ignored this young lady. We saw how he moved through the crowd and pretending like she didn't exist when she was holding the Biden sign. It seemed like, y'all, I don't know if y'all saw it or not. Maybe it's just me. I seem like I saw something in her eyes that just made me feel like that was a pivotal moment for her. Like, she was so anticipatory of that moment. Like, she really wanted to meet the man. Like, she really believed. Like, she really drank the Kool-Aid of the whole situation. Well, y'all, and I'm scrolling. Joe Biden did an interview, because see, it's something about that minority vote that's going on right now that makes it seem so important, makes it seem so viable, makes it seem so vital to the circumstance and the situation that everybody's pushing for it. Hey, it's not one-sided. Look, these parties, y'all, and people can call me what they want to on this platform, but I understand, having studied this stuff, these are two wings on the same bird. Forgive me for looking down, y'all. I'm trying to find this video. These are two sides of the same coin. So we understand it from that perspective. That's how we see it. Everybody's going for the minority vote. Everybody feels the minority vote is vital and important. Well, when you got a president who don't really know what day it is, when you got a president who I don't believe ties his own shoes, well, then you come into a circumstance like this where he can look past certain people. Well, how do you know that? Because I know his history. I know, folks, he's connected himself to in the past in his long political career. I know what he said. I know how he's acted. Even recently when he said, y'all, they gonna put y'all back in chains. Oh, what you trying to say, Joe? You're trying to say, oh, are you acknowledging that at one point somebody was in some chains? You're going to admit that now? It's part of American history, y'all. We got to embrace it and deal with it for what it is. All right, here we go. We getting there, y'all. We getting there. We getting there. Did you hear me filibustering? I was trying to find a video. Susan is in the building. Thank you for being here, Susan. Southern Cookie Cutter says, I'm over here rolling on the floor laughing. She out there connecting. You and Katie laughing together. Susan says, hello. I like this channel. It's very informative. Susan, we trying to put it down out here. If I get a chance to get in your child's ear, Susan, I'm going to tell him or her, I went to college so you don't have to. I went to grad school so you don't have to. Lean on me as a resource and understand that everything I say here is my opinion. Yes, I'm not stating none of this stuff as fact. I hope everyone will see me in this instance and go fact check me. Do your own due diligence. Check me. It's okay. But this is based on my experience, my lived experience, and my education. Y'all, this woman, like this Black girl who had such anticipation of meeting her hero, stood there with a Biden-Harris poster, said, this is my opportunity, y'all. Finally made it to the front row. You finally get your chance and you say, my heart is pounding. Here comes my hero. And he skips right over you as if you don't exist. Well, it's not the only story.